add drone. All right, well, it's fine, everybody. Return to your normal, peaceful lives, for I have apparently done the needful here. Okay, hotel to pilot house. I guess no one's going to stop me, right? Not like anybody could stop me, but, you know. Okay. Good enough to me. Oh, I should probably save. Boop. Let's go. Oh my god, it's such a long walk. Can I get any method of transportation that's not walking? That would be nice. That would be swell, quaint, candid.
I could use a new pair of glasses.
Can't imagine where you misplaced your old pair.
A steel shampoo bottle? Okay. Oh, you have nowhere else to go? Oh.
What a coincidence.
What? Are you okay?
I see the adjutant sent her own freely.
You know, I never imagined Spencer Woolrich without a little Halcyon Helen.
You piece of shit. You guys fucking slugs in here. What are you doing with slugs in here? Alright, now I'm taking your shit. What do you got?
Hey, you look like you need some stuff. Fancy watch? Spare cufflink? Single earring? You want it, I've got it.
Show me what you got for sale. Wow, 1,300 credits for a concierge livery third class. Oh my god, what a fucking deal. Toss balls, car, necklaces, corporation services. Hey, can I sell here? You want to buy my junk? You don't have anything worthwhile? I know, all your stuff's fucking garbage. I have, like, plenty of this. Plenty of junk. Look at all this junk up here. Yeah, the best thing you've got is this, but I already have, like, a million of these. I have a concierge outfit already, don't I? There you go. Bam. Easy. I don't need what you got. You ain't got what I need. All right. Goodbye, lady. I can't open this door, right? No, I cannot. Okay. So I'm out of here. That sounded bad. I guess that's okay. All right. Oh, I should probably go up here. There's nothing. Nothing? All right. Good, 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 good. Oh, I need to go in that room I didn't go into because it was full of poison. Yeah. All right. There we go. Let's grab everything we can in this room because it is clearly mine. And that and that. Give me this. Give me the thing. Thank you. Rude. I need to be able to hack stuff, don't I? Workbench. Oh, do I have a modify the gun? Stall mod. Do I have a ammo? Holy crap. Magnum? Range weapon mod. Magazine increases the amount of ammunition the weapon magazine carries. Okay. Wow. What is that? Oh, by 9? Mag 2 power? Oh, changes the plasma, the damage type. Yeah, it's already plasma, so I don't need it to do that. Let's see. Okay, yeah. I want to put deep damage per... Yeah, okay. So I want to do... I want to put that on. I want to put crit damage. Yep, crit damage. And then scope. Yeah, ranged weapon spread. Hell yeah. Bam. How much better is this gun now? Woo. A lot better. All right. Let's go. No. Ooh, yep. Let's go here. Inventory and that pistol. Replacing that pistol. Oh, my God. So much stronger. Oh, wait. Not that way. This way? All right. Oh, free stuff. Yoink. 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 Probably shouldn't be stealing all that. I don't know whose it is. But it doesn't matter. Haha. It's mine now. That's the best part of stealing. You don't have to think about whose stuff it is. Concerning that things can live this high up in the clouds. I guess maybe we're just like bringing birds or whatever. Oh my god, that's so huge. How big is this expansion? This DLC is pretty large. I thought it was only going to be like a 4-hour DLC at most, but apparently I was wrong. They wanted to pack every little bit left that they had. Though I guess it would be a lot faster if I just stopped playing around and talking to every stupid idiot person I ran into. That is my fault, interacting with the game.
Wow! I know you! You're the adjutant's right hand!
Sure.
Sure he's not in the museum.
Even if he is, no one will think you dress the same as him on purpose.
I was at breakfast first. If anything, he's dressed the same as me.
I don't care what you're talking about.
No, I never imagined Spencer Woolridge would outlive Halcyon Helen.
Okay. I don't know what any of you guys are talking about.
Timeline discrepancy detected.
I hate this.
Discrepancy detected. Rizzo's company policy clearly states that all proprietary mascots must exhibit signs of physical life.
Puncture wounds near his collarbone.
Excellent observation, Inspector. Have you deduced a possible cause of death?
Firearms.
Unusually small entry wounds indicate exotic weaponry. Closest approximations are 1. Incident involving a game of darts. 2. The Needler.
The Needler?
Yes, Inspector. The Needler. The spoke handgun carried and wielded by Halcyon Helen. Famously deployed by Halcyon Helen in Terror on Monarch. This weapon was responsible for executing the Chief of the Savages, played by Spencer Woolridge.
You think he missed his outfit?
This unit is incapable of providing ethical advice. This unit is also incapable of answering rhetorical questions.
I'll take his things. Potential evidence. Alright. Thanks. Taking that too. And that. Well, I knew I should have asked him. I knew I should have stopped him. Knew I should have not let him go. I tried intimidating him. I tried to stop. I should have just killed him, honestly. I knew the moment he ran away, someone else was going to kill him. I knew it. I knew it. It's so obvious. Literally every single person's been getting killed in this entire stupid thing. That's how a mystery works, right? Every single person that leaves off screen is dead because...
Timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
Somewhere else? Oh.
This empty bottle of spirits does not belong to any known corporate brand. Suspicious residue detected.
Oh, what kind? High concentration of ethanol.
Excellent deduction, Inspector. Imbibing of unauthorized beverages is strictly prohibited under Rizzo's company law. Ingredients include antiseptic alcohol, sucrose, and unidentifiable miscellaneous organic material. Closest match. Counterfeit spirits available at the Piraeus spaceport.
Alright. So now we gotta go to the super spaceport. What do you got up here? Anything good? Terminal. Hell yeah, mine now. Yoink. All right, unofficial logs. I password locked this directory. Pretty sure no one in management can crack it, even if they do start checking up on us. I saw Spencer Woolrich order 4 different meals and send them all back. What a refined palate. The other day, Halcyon Helen was enjoying a spectrum on the terrace. The stars really are, just like the rest of us. Some of the rangers started tussling in one of the fountains. The gardener, Automex, spent hours propping the flowers back up. What fun, guys. Initial if you see one of the following on your shift. First to three wins. Teacup candids in matching outfits. This should really count twice, one for each candid. Someone falling off edge of island. tryst in greenhouse. It's all windows. Why would anyone else? Why would anyone do this? Petoria slams into hotel window. Raptodon or primal on hotel island. Wow, worth it. Clear skies, distant storm, clear skies, distant storm, clear skies. Okay. Worth it, I guess. I don't know, maybe there was some information inside of that terminal that could be useful later on. I'll never know because I don't know. I don't know. I really don't understand much about the mystery so far. The game kind of auto-leads you through what you need to be doing, right? It doesn't really give you much leniency for self-discovery. You can, I guess, in theory, just run around the map and explore yourself, but is there any value in that? No, I'd say. No. Speaking of, what do we got here? Okay, so we've still got the Productivity Queen, the Prince of Tossball. Oh. The leads you found indicate that Birdie had planned to meet the mascot there and is now hiding out in the spaceport's cantina. Well, if you're the asshole who made me walk all the way over here, then yeah, let's have a good time here. Yeah, Prince of... Okay, so you're that way. All right. Yeah, come to the entrance here. We're gonna break some legs, if you know what I'm saying. Like, literally. Like, we're gonna literally go break someone's legs. Like, that's the whole... Yeah. Anyways, that way. That way. Okay. Oh, my God. More of these guys? Get out of here, dude. What was that? Oh, my God. That was great. It did, like, and then it just, like, broke its neck on the thing. FBI, open up. Oh, crap. I was trying to click through that. That's my bad. Ew, he had something in his hand. Gross. All right. Anyways, here I am to do some things. I don't care. Well, that's a lot of ammo. Do you guys even need all that ammo? I'll be honest with you. You guys don't do much as it is.
Inspector, good to see you. Let me just grant you access and... Welcome to the Piraeus Spaceport.
Yo, sweet. That was easy. F5 to save. All right. Well, let's go ahead and walk on over to the spaceport. Looks like I didn't need to do anything after all. I just showed up and he was like, welcome in. Here's a free spaceport for you. Beautiful, isn't it? Beautiful this time of year. All right. I have to go inside the building. Take everything I possibly can out here first, just in case. Let's go. Transitioning. Come on. There we go. Still loading. Oh.
Hey, you. We've been looking for you. And by we, I mean Slug. Been real busy sniffing around Eridanos for clues, haven't you, Inspector? See, Sluglight Underground don't like that much. Should have kept your nose where it belonged, Inspector. Slug's sick of all your meddling in their affairs. Our affairs, I mean. We're... Draw, you damn breadworm! Draw!
What? Okay, this is a farce.
You want to say that again, pal?
Think about it. Slug asked me to investigate, and now it wants me dead?
Quick, everyone! Get him! Take him! We need fire!
Yeah, back up these nuts and dead. See, look, like I said, guys, when you come and try to fight a god, you're going to end up dying. It's just a matter of life. Got a job for anyone with a ready gun hand and empty pockets. There's an inspector looking into the murder of Halcyon Helen. My client wants you to cross them off. Don't worry about subtlety. In fact, don't be subtle. Just make sure that once you agree to the job, you visit the rearmorist by a bunk. Put on some uniforms you'll find folded beneath the mattress. After that, feel free to cause a ruckus. Be sure to let them know slug territory is off limits. The reward's 4,000 bits plus all the enhancing chemicals you could ever want. What? 40,000 bits? Yo, I'm in the... Can I get 40,000 bits? This fucking person was like, wow. Sucks for them, I guess. She just watched all that happen. Alright. Well, I came here as asked. I guess you're a person.
Hello. Welcome to Eridanos Dry Goods and Sundry. I'm Marketeer Joseph.
Okay. Oh, so your title is Marketeer, right? Ever refer to yourself as Marketer?
Oh, I see you've read some of my poems. Very clever, Inspector. Yes, my pen name is the Marketeer, though I also use it in certain business dealings. Wait a moment. Why do you ask?
This?
Hey now, hey. Let's all be reasonable here. I'm just a middleman. None of this was my idea. Occasionally, jobs requiring discretion arrive here from the hotel. Always anonymous and always lucrative. For a sizable cut, I set these jobs up and ask no questions. Somebody sent me a note telling me they wanted you dead. I don't know who, and I don't know why. I swear.
You were hired by an anonymous note to hire someone else by anonymous note?
Yeah, of course. It's called a paper trail. Give me a little credit. I'm a professional. I've got to have some standards.
Okay. Either you're twisting my arm or you're an idiot. I don't know what to make of you.
I understand your distrust, but look at me in my place of business. What would I stand to gain from destroying you versus how much I stand to lose if discovered? You're welcome to remain suspicious, but in the meantime, you're completely welcome to browse my wares at your leisure. No surcharge. Again, terribly sorry. Welcome back.
What was that? Bypass shunt? I think I have a lot of these, right? I think I have plenty of bypass shunts. I don't even know how many I have. 10? Is that how many I have? I don't know how many I have. Let's see. Okay. You have literally nothing I want. And you only have 16 bits in the register? Bro, come on now. This is the best your shitty shop's got to offer. Truly, truly pathetic.
Welcome.
Next time, might I recommend that you don't do that? You see, I'm not a man who appreciates being played around with. The mask of Lord Cavendish, who revealed himself to be the mass marketeer in the thrilling final episode of the infamous serial. He was shortly executed by the authorities for extensive vigilantism without the proper vigilante license. Remember, our bureaucracy exists for a reason, and to surpass it for however noble a cause is to rebel against the entirety of Halcyon. Wow, sucks for Halcyon, because I've been literally doing that my entire life, and literally no one has stopped me. I wonder why that is. Alrighty then.
Hey, you. I got something I need to speak with you about.
Me? Alright.
Hey there. Word around the spaceport is that you came in on the unreliable. You a new crewmate?
Wait, aren't you literally the guy, the lawyer guy I met inside of the place? Are you just the same looking character model? They just didn't even have the bother to make a different looking guy? Wait a second, what the hell? Actually, Unreliable's my ship. I'm Hawthorne, the captain of the Unreliable.
Cut the shit. I know Hawthorne's captain of that ship, but I know you ain't him. You want to try again?
I'm Rocket Man. Sorry to tell you, but Hawthorne's dead.
I see. Well, this would have been easier with Hawthorne, but I hope that if you're flying his ship, it means you're a freelancer, too. Wonder if you can help me.
Listen.
I run an outfit for the moving of less than legal goods. There's a particular piece of cargo needs delivering to a particular individual in the spaceport. Thing is, I don't know where the cargo is right now. The crewmate who handles that is in the clink for getting a little too disorderly in town. We've already attracted too much attention. Too risky to visit her myself. That's where you come in. You help us out, I'll give you an equal cut of our pay.
All right.
Great to hear. First, you need to go meet the crewmate who got herself jailed. Cassidy Mills is the name. She'll know where the cargo is.
All right, if you say so. How will she know I'm working with you?
Oh, yeah, right. We have a secret phrase. I like boneless spratwurst. Say that, and she'll know you're a friend.
Sounds good. I'll get going.
Be seeing ya. Remember, Cassidy's at the constabulary. She might be a little wary, so be careful.
All right. Anyways, hello.
What do you want?
You're Black Hole Birdie, right?
Not so loud. How'd you know it was me?
I'm an inspector and a goddamn good one.
Yeah, that makes sense. You must be a good one to sniff me out. I'm in no mood to sign autographs, and I hate disappointing fans. So I'm lying low. You know, incompleto.
Incompleto. You mean incognito.
Oh, yeah. I guess it's kinda neato. Oh, what's it matter? Helen's gone. She's gone, and nothing I do will bring her back. I've been trying to find who did this. That's what she would do. Track down the killer and bring them to justice.
Oh, yeah?
But I'm stumped. And not very clever. Being bright was always Helen's thing.
Maybe I can help. I was hired to solve her murder.
Oh, so you're the inspector.
I just said that.
You have more luck figuring things out than me. You probably want to ask me some questions, huh? I'm sure you're asking everybody questions so you can find Helen's killer. So,
yeah.
How do I help?
Why'd you smash up your picnic with Helen?
Oh, the picnic. Right. I get real mad sometimes. Ugly mad. Something I've been working on, but when Helen said we were through, I lost it.
Must have been rough.
Helen meant everything to me. I didn't take the split well. And now I can never apologize.
What'd you do after the picnic?
I got blotto with the other Rangers.
What?
You know, soaked, muddled, preserved, drunk. The team noticed I was in a bad way when I got back to the hotel. When I told them Helen and I were Splitsville, they wanted to cheer me up. We were up the pole before evening. The hotel staff said we was bothering the other guests on account of all the crying and yelling and practice body tackling. Zeke said we should move elsewhere, get some air.
Probably a good call.
We ended up at the Wilderness Exploitation Reserve. I think somebody wanted to pet a woolly cow. There was this one cow off away from the others. Zeke figured it'd be a laugh to get her drunk. One thing led to another, and I think we might have maybe, you know, stolen her.
Oh, what'd you steal a cow for?
I don't know. We were drunk, and we made bad choices. She was all alone. I know how that feels now. It's so hard to be all by your lonesome. My memory's a little muddled after that. I guess me and the team got split up, because I know I was on my own at the pilot house for a time.
Okay. Anyone from the pilot house back that up?
I reckon not. See, I went to the weather station. I was looking for where Helen stashed her data pad for safekeeping, right? She'd asked me to get it, mind. I wasn't stealing. I'm no thief.
And did you find it?
Sure did. Only there was a guard out there who found me. She started yelling about how I was trespassing and in serious trouble. Thing is, it was real dark out there. So dark, she couldn't tell who I was.
Sure this guard couldn't ID you?
Real sure. It was dark as night gets. Plus, I've got small veins. Anyway, I didn't much feel like trying to explain why I was out there, or why I was drunk, and holding someone else's data pad, and also maybe crying a little, so I booked it. Ran like the Rangers were down by three, and I just bronzed the toss ball in the Friday zone.
Okay, well, I know you weren't sprinting for the Sunday zone. Where'd you go?
I don't know where I was going, but my legs took me straight to my friend's... I mean, to my... fridge-rator.
Okay, well... I'm gonna need a name.
I don't want to tell you. I'll get in trouble.
Not having a witness puts you in much bigger trouble.
Look, I talked to Oryk, okay? Oryk West. Hangs out around the spaceport. He's the one who taught me the breathing exercises I use to calm down.
Okay. Now, is that so hard?
Don't get the wrong idea, okay? Oryk's not a bad guy. He's just got an unusual job.
Doing
so now
what?
You have the whole story. After I talked to Oryk, I went back to the hotel. Up the next morning with Helen's data pad in my hand and the hangover to end all hangovers. Don't know if I'll ever drink again.
Yep, everyone who says that after they... Everyone who has a hangover says they'll never drink again. But you know what they do? They look hideously ugly while they go and drink again. So shut the hell up. Where's that data pad?
Oh, I mean the hard stuff. Beer doesn't count.
Anyway, right.
You ought to take Helen's data pad.
Hello,
maybe you'll have better luck understanding her notes. Either she was writing in code or I'm dumber than a bag of hammers. I tried for hours to crack her notes, but it's like I said, being bright was Helen's thing.
All right, I'll take a look at them.
Okay. And listen, I want to help you find her killer, Inspector. I knew Helen better than anybody. And it could be handy to have a guy like me around, in case anybody gives you trouble.
Can't let a suspect be part of the investigation.
I'll head back to the Grand Colonial then, unless you need me for anything else.
Let's see. Nah, you're free to go. Thank you very much for the data pad. That helps immensely. Can I hack this security guard? How's it going? It's mine now. Oh, I need this. Oh, I took it out. Good thing no one noticed I was in there. Very handy. Very useful. Oh, I guess that thing. Okay, I don't need that.
Hey,
oh, hey.
Over here.
Oh, me?
Hey there. You're looking to unwind, friend. Maybe you're on your way to the bar for a good time. Maybe you're interested in something a little better than beer or Adreno. Something with a little more kick.
To better than beer?
Bold claim, I know. But I wouldn't lie to you, friend. The name's Auric. I deal in, shall we say, holistic pharmaceuticals, natural substances and the like. You know, alternative stuff. I know. Ooh, it came out of the ground. That's where worms live. I get it. I do. Why go for that homegrown shit when you could be pumping your body full of effort accelerators? Says it right on the Anticleo's box. Better than nature, right? Well, I'm gonna let you in on a little secret, pal. Those pharmaceuticals the corporations manufacture, not all of them are as good for you as the board wants you to believe.
What? Really?
Alternatives. That's the way to go, pal. Trust me. No matter what ails you, I got what you need.
I want to ask you some questions about Bertie Holcomb.
Wait, you ain't a sheriff, right? You gotta tell me if you're a sheriff.
I don't think I have jurisdiction here. let's see. I'm a freelance inspector brought on to investigate the death of Helen.
I'll be honest. I don't really know where that puts us.
I'm not here to bring you trouble. I just want to talk.
All right, fine. Yeah, I know Bertie. So what?
Was Bertie with you the night Halcyon Helen died?
Yeah. Damn shame about that. Bertie thought the world of Helen, you know. He showed up drunk at my place wanting to talk about the breakup. Helen dumped him, he said. Boy, was he in a bad way. I'd never seen him like that before. We talked for a while, and when he felt better, I sent him back to the hotel. Told him to drink more water and get some sleep.
Let's see. Heard you taught him some breathing techniques.
Yeah, that was me. Birdie's got a temper, but he's not a bad kid, you know? He's trying to work on it.
How you know Bertie?
He may or may not buy alternatives from me from time to time. A little diluted mantis or essence here, a little vitamin B negative there.
You have a substance problem?
Nah. What Bertie's got is a stress problem. He's stressed out of his mind, the poor guy. Everyone knows his name. Can't turn around without having to sign an autograph. Then you throw in playing tossball for a living. Violence like that, it does things to a body. It does things to the head.
What do you mean tossball does things to the head?
Come on. Bertie's a damn good hacker. But taking that many blows to the noggin would scramble anyone's upstairs business. I know it's knocked a few of his memories loose. I worry about him, that's all. He's a good kid. Got a good heart.
That's all for now. Thanks for confirming the alibi. Tired of sleeping on the ship. Oh, it comes with free stuff. And trash? Someone didn't throw out their fucking trash? Bruh. All right.